inverse of a matrix. That's going to be a very important lecture for us. But before that, we have to talk about adjoint of a matrix. Please note that adjoint of a matrix can be found only for square matrix. And what is this concept adjoint of a matrix? Now let's say if I take any matrix, let's say matrix A, let's say I take a matrix A of order 3. Let me call as the matrix C by replacing the elements with their cofactors. Now what is cofactor? Listen to this concept very, very carefully. Cofactor of a matrix, a cofactor of an element. Let's say I want to find cofactor of A11. Okay. Then what do? We do minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 1. Why this 1 plus 1? Because A11 belongs to first row, first column, into minor of A11. Now what is minor? Minor means, I will write it down over here, minor of A11. Minor means, hide the column and the row in which A11 falls. Whatever number you see, let's say if it is only one number left, then that number would be the minor. But if you see four numbers like this, then do a cross multiplication just like you do it in determinants. So it will be A22 minus A3, A22 into A33 minus A32 into A22. That would be called the minor. So cofactor of that element is nothing but minor of that element along with the sign like this. So in general, I can say cofactor of Aij will be minus 1 to the power I plus j minor of Aij. Is that fine?
Suppose we have 4.
Then whatever 9 elements you see, you have to find the determinant of it. So minor is nothing but the determinant of the matrix that you get or the sub matrix that you get after hiding the row and the column to which that element falls. So Shira was asking a question, had there been a 4x4, what would have been the minor of A11?
9 elements.
There would be 9 elements over here left. Determinant of that itself would be the minor. Minor with the sign is the cofactor. Is that fine? Now, let's say the cofactors are written in the matrix C like this. Okay. If you transpose the cofactor matrix, normally we write cofactor matrix as COF bracket A. That is cofactor of A. Okay. So A has been given to you. If you make a matrix by replacing the elements with the respective cofactors, the matrix obtained is called the cofactor matrix. If you transpose the cofactor matrix, then you get something called the adjoint of A. So if you transpose this, you get the adjoint of A. Is that fine? Understanding adjoint is very important before we understand the inverse of a matrix. Because we can actually find the inverse of a matrix from its adjoint. Okay, I'll come to it a little later on time. In the same position. That's why I said replace the elements with their cofactors. So A11 cofactor would be replacing A11. A12's cofactor would be replacing A12 and so on. Okay. Now I'll give you a question. Find the adjoint of A if your A is 1, 3, minus 5, 2, 4, 0, minus 3, 6, 1. Okay. Let's take up this exercise together. So you're revising class 11 simultaneously, right? Physics you're revising class 11 from there, maths you're doing. Two topics going simultaneously for you. Can somebody go and tell Neera sir you're too low?
No. Give that.
With an app screen.
Shriya.
Okay.
What did you go do?
Shh. Fine. Let's talk about the cofactor matrix first. Now, cofactor matrix, first of all, I would like to know from you, what is the cofactor for 1? Now, for 1, you hide the column in the row in which 1 falls. What do you see? You see these 4 elements, isn't it? So, 4 into 1, 4, 6 into 0 is 0, 4 minus 0 is 4, okay? So, I'm writing cofactor of A over here. So, it will be 4. Remember, 1 comes with a sign of minus 1 to the power 2. So there is no sign along with 4, or at least positive 1. What about 3? First of all, 3, the sign attached to it is minus. So write a minus. Then hide the column and the row in which 3 falls. So it will be 2, so it will be minus 2. Correct? Take your time. If you have not understood this, please ask again. Next, for minus 5, the sign would be positive again.
Positive.
Correct? Positive, so I won't write anything. So hide the column, hide the row. What do you see? You see these 4 elements?
24.
12 minus minus 12.
24.
That's 24. Is that fine? Next.
Negative.
For 2, again the sign would be negative. Hide the column, hide the row and the column which it falls. So you have 3 minus 5, 6 and 1. So 3 minus 30.
33.
So altogether the answer will be minus 33. 33 is the minor, minus was the sign. So minus sign into minor will become your cofactor.
9.
4. 4 comes in second row, second column, correct? So sign will be positive. 16. So hide this, so it will be
16.
Minus 14. Correct? For 0, again 0 comes in the second row, third column, so it will have a minus sign already. So hide the column, hide the row. So you see 6 plus 9, which is 15. Please understand this process of finding cofactor matrix very, very clearly. Next, minus 3, again plus sign,
plus 20.
Hide the row, hide the column, so you see plus 20, 0 minus minus 20, clear? No? How does this? The negative sign of the number doesn't matter, the negative sign attached to its position matters. I plus j, minus 1 to the power, I plus j is the same. Minus 3 in the sign would be minus 1 to the power 3 plus 1. It belongs to the third row, first column. So that's still positive. So I didn't write any sign over it. No, hide this. 3 into 0, 0. Minus 4 into minus 5. So minus of minus 20. Okay. Then for this it will be minus sign again.
Minus 10.
So hide this, it will be plus 10, which means minus into plus 10, which is minus 10. Okay. What about for this? Again a plus sign?
Minus 2.
Plus, minus, plus, minus 6.
Minus
2. So it will be hide this 4 minus 6, which is minus 2. Yes or no? Okay. Now the process of doing this sometimes leads to lot, not sometimes, many a times leads to lot of silly mistakes. People do mistakes normally in two things. Yes, calculating, doing the determined minus part of it, and second mistake is the sign associated with it. So these are two mistakes that happen. So for a 3x3 matrix, which is the most commonly asked matrices for you to find an adjoint, I will tell you a shorter way to get the cofactor matrix and hence the adjoint. By the way, if I have to find the adjoint here, it's very simple. What do I have to do? Just transpose it. So your answer will be 4 minus 2, 24, minus 23, minus 14, minus 15, 20, minus 10, minus 2. Correct? Now I tell you a shortcut way to find out the cofactor and hence the adjoint in a much faster way. Okay? But again, don't use it in school very explicitly. You may use it just at the rougher part to test your result. Okay. Let's say I want to find out the cofactor matrix for this matrix. Okay, cofactor matrix for this matrix. So what I'll do, I'll first write down the elements as they have been given in the matrix itself. Okay. Copy the first row. Copy the second row. Correct? Copy the first column here. Copy the second column here. Okay. Erase the first row, first column now. Okay. Now, no need to bother about sign. Just do these multiplications as I have shown you by the arrow mark over here. And keep writing it here. So 4 minus 0 will be 4. 0 minus 2 will be minus 2. 12 plus 12 would be 24. Minus 30 minus 3 will be minus 33. 1 minus 15 will be minus 14. Minus 9 minus 6 will be minus 15. 0 minus 20 will be plus 20. Minus 10 minus 0 will be this. 4 minus 6 will be minus 2. Your cofactor is ready with you. No need to do those plus minus. Yeah, sure. You have to say once more.
Is it specific to 3 into 3?
Yes, just repeating it again. Like after deleted, you're asking. Okay, I'll repeat one thing. And I'll take another example. Let's take another example. By the way, this will give you the cofactor. You have to transpose it to get the adjoint. Okay? So let's say I ask you this question. Find the adjoint of, let's say, 3 minus 2, 5, 1, minus 1, minus 6, 7, 2, 5. Now, again I'm repeating the process. First, copy down the same as such. So 3 minus 2, 5, 1, minus 1, minus 6, 7, 2, 5. Okay. Then copy the first row below the this, copy the second row, correct? Okay. So far so good. Now, copy the first column here, okay? Copy the second column over here. Is that fine? Now, listen to this. Erase the first row completely, erase the first column completely. Okay. And now start cross multiplication, whatever you do in determinants. Okay. So this will be minus 5. Yeah. So cofactor of A would be minus 5 plus 12, 7. Minus 42 minus 5. Minus 47, then 2 plus 7, 9, 10 plus 10, 20, 15 minus 35, minus 20, minus 14, minus 6, minus 20 again. Then 12 plus 5, 17. Then 5 plus 18, 23. Then what do you get? Minus 3 plus 2. Is that fine? Okay. So adjoint will be nothing but the transpose of whatever you have got. Is that fine? For a 2x2, it's even simpler. Let me give you an example of a 2x2. Let's say we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, find the adjoint of A. So first what we'll do? First we'll find the cofactor of A. Cofactor of A matrix. So in cofactor, what do we do? 1, hide this, you see a 4, right? So write a 4. For 2 it will be? Minus 3. For 3 it will be? Minus 2. For 3 it will be minus 2, because now it belongs to first row, second row, first column position. For 4 it will be? Plus 1. Now if you transpose it, what do you get? You get 4 minus 3 minus 2, 1. Isn't it? Now the moral of the story is, exchange the position of these two and change their signs. Correct? Exchange the position of these two and change their signs. That means if it was plus, make it negative, if it was negative, make it positive, whatever it is. So if I ask you, matrix P, let's say 3 minus 6, 5 minus 2, what is the adjoint of P? First, minus 2, 3, 6, minus 5. Okay, for 4 by 4, any rule right now, 4x4 maybe will not be asked also. Very rare that a 4x4 can come. In fact, it has never come. Now we talk about adjoint properties. What is actually adjoint helpful in? So this shortcut is fine with you? I don't think they will stop you from using this till you find the, till you get a correct answer. Nobody checks how have you got the cofactor for each element. 9 elements cofactor checking is a waste of time, because almost 30 students would be there in your class, right?
44.
Yeah. I don't think you should check, sit and check all the 9 elements. She may only check the final result, irrespective of how you got it. Boards also, they say if you don't think a mistake is the answer, nobody knows the penalty. Okay. And if you worried so much, no. Just do it in the rough work and write four factors of these elements from those that answer is
smart.
Okay, fine. Now we talk about properties of adjoint. Properties of adjoint of a matrix. Write down first property. First property. And the most important one, A into adjoint of A is first of all commutative, Secondly, the result for this is quite astonishing to us. It's actually a scalar matrix where the tidal element position would be nothing but the determinant of the matrix A itself. I would like all of you to verify this. Let me take a simple example to understand this. Let's say A is 1, 3, 2, minus 4. Okay. Fine. But I'm taking a 2 by 2 so that our working is very less. I don't want to take a 3 by 3, it takes a lot of time. I would like all of you to give me what is the adjoint of A, given that I have already told you the trick.
Minus
4, 1.
Okay.
All of you perform this operation A into adjoint of A. So multiply A with the adjoint of A. No need to check this one because it has to be same. So 1, 3, 2, minus 4 multiplied with minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, 1. What do you get? Minus 4, minus 6, minus 10. Minus 3, minus 3 plus 3, 0.
Minus 10, 0, 0, minus.
Minus 8 plus 8, 0. Minus 6 minus 4 minus 10. Do you see that you can actually write it as minus 10 times 1, 0, 0, 1? Okay. It is nothing but minus 10 times I2. And minus 10, you would be surprised to know that if you find the determinant of this matrix, that's minus 4 minus 6, which is minus 10. That's why we have this property that A into adjoint of A, where A is, let's say, a square matrix of order n. Then A into adjoint of A would be adjoint of A into A, and that product will be A determinant into In. So basically, this is which type of a matrix? This is a scalar matrix. Remember when we are doing types of matrix, I told you scalar matrix is a matrix where the diagonal elements are the same non-zero scalar quantity, correct? Now from this property comes out the concept of inverse of a matrix. We'll talk about it when I'm talking about inverse. As of now, this property, please note it down. Okay, next. Adjoint of AB follows the law of reversal. It's adjoint of B into adjoint of A. Again, law of reversal. Where else did we see this law? In transpose. AB transpose is B transpose, A transpose. And you'll also see this law coming up in inverse. AB inverse is B inverse, A inverse. We'll talk about it in some time. Third property right now. Adjoint of A transpose is as good as transposing the adjoint itself. Adjoint of A transpose is as good as transposing the adjoint of A itself.